your first sort of sequel. Mm-hmm. Fans are treated to a more in-depth look of Russell Brand's eldest Snow.
That's right.
And Get Him to the Greek.
Mm-hmm.
And now we're getting a deeper peek into Debbie and Pete's life. If you were asked to do another sort of sequel, which character would you like to revisit?
That's a very good question. Maybe, in the past we've talked about, should we do anything off of Superbad or Pineapple Express? And if Seth Rogen and Evan Goldberg ever wanted to do that, I think that would be pretty cool. I don't know. I'd like to know where Dewey Cox is right now. We could do a spinoff about Dewey Cox's wife.
Many people would love to know that as well.
Where's Kristen Wiig's character from Walk Hard?
And then in the movie, the only sort of reference to Knocked Up's Ben and Allison was via the magic cookie.
That's right, yes.
But I understand you've come up with a whole backstory as to where they are now. What can you tell me about that?
Well, we think she got a job in local news. She could be anywhere. I say she's in Duluth.
Duluth.
Right now. And Seth just watches the kids all day.
Wonderful. They've had more.
That's right. He's a house husband.
Now, your daughters, Maud and Iris, have grown up so much since Knocked Up's premiere, both as young ladies and as scene-stealing actresses.
Yeah.
What was it like directing them in this film?
You know, it was really fun because they have, they understand how it works. But their scenes are about their sibling rivalry. So when I shoot the scenes, I get three cameras and they'll do the script, but then I'll just have them debate something like, is Iris too young to watch South Park? And they'll just get into a fight for 10 minutes and I can just film it. And if something's good, I put it in the movie. And they do know that they're supposed to be funny. They're not just losing their minds, but they are mad. Their scenes are driven by hate.
And I understand that the Lost debate was actually something that actually happened in real life.
Maud started watching so many Lost. I mean, she watched the entire series in about 6 weeks. And we thought, are we bad parents for letting our child watch 7 hours a day of Lost? We didn't really know how to control it. We just wanted to end and then not let her do it again. And then, of course, she's like, I got a new show, Breaking Bad. So what do you do then?
Next is going to be like Homeland.
Yeah, I know. American Horror Story.
Now, lastly, just kind of wrapping up, what is it about this film that you're hoping audiences will take away?
It is about commitment and all the obstacles to making your life work. And any story that's about how people get through it and are there for each other, love each other, that's the kind of movie I like.
Definitely. I feel like it is such a highly relatable film that, like, someone in their 20s can look at it and be like, my parents have had that exact same conversation. Yeah. Is that something that you kind of pulled out of your personal life?
Well, to me, even though it's called This Is 40, there's characters who are 8 and 13 and 25 and also in their 60s. So, it's kind of about all the different ages. And I relate to, every phase of all of them.